In this tutorial I will teach you how to draw a simple 3D object in SketchUp and export it as an image file. You will learn how to first set up your SketchUp program and toolbars and how to use them. I use this program for my own exporting business all the time. SketchUp allows users to imagine spaces in three dimensions, this being the foundation to many successful entrepreneurs that are able to apply 3D design to their everyday life. Let us begin. Initially, SketchUp displays a few basic tools in the custom toolbar. Once you have displayed the large tool set, you do not need these duplicated tools, so in the next few steps you will replace them with some more helpful tools. Choose View, and then Toolbars to open the customized toolbar window. Here you will see dozens of tools you can add. After adding you can move them around, but try not to move them constantly as you will get used to their placement and find yourself clicking tools, and zipping right along. So let us go ahead and add some toolbars. Take off large tool set. Here you can see it displayed on the left side of your screen. A nice feature on SketchUp is the instructor window. Go to Windows and select Instructor. The instructor window combines brief step-by-step text with simple animations. It's helpful when you are learning a new tool or technique, and is not too disruptive or distracting. Let me demonstrate. Previously known by SketchUp fans as the Value Control Box, abbreviated as VCB, but now more commonly referred to as the Measurement Toolbar, is a very important tool that will save you a lot of time if you can master it. You can toggle it as a toolbar or use it in its default position at the bottom right of your screen. Depending on where you reside in the unit of measure in your country, you may want to change this right away. Go to the top menu bar and click Window, then Model Info, to change the unit of measure. The other information can be viewed as well to update your preferences. The unit tab I selected length units, and changed it to decimal, and importantly under precision I selected nil millimeter. We need to now add another toolbar. Go to View, Toolbars, and look for Styles. Select the tick box next to it and the Styles toolbar will appear at the top of the screen. With this tool you can make the object see-through, as we will demonstrate later. Let us now draw a simple shape in order to get to know some more of the tools on the toolbar. Select the Line Draw tool, and left-click on the so-called point of origin, which is the point at which all the axes converge. Do not hold in the button, only click once. On the bottom right of the screen in the VCP you will see the line length being displayed. See how the program tells you in what plane you are drawing? It will switch between red, green and blue depending on your mouse movements. Look what happens when I hide the drawing axes. It is almost impossible to tell in which direction the line is drawn in a 3D environment. The lines being drawn have properties that can be changed under View, Edge Style, whilst the flat faces can also be made to look differently. And this was briefly discussed earlier when we added the Styles toolbar on the top right of the menu bar, where this tool can be accessed to change the appearance of the object too. I am not sure if you noticed, but the object, or point of origin, is actually quite far away into the distance. I can tell this by how long the line being drawn is measuring in the VCP, at the bottom right of the screen. If I wanted to make an object to be 1000 millimeters long, in other words, about the size of a cardboard box, I would have to move closer to the object. To do that you have to scroll down with your scroll button on your mouse. See how I zoomed in? At first it may seem that nothing is happening, but if I now redraw the line, it can clearly be seen that the line measuring more than 6,000 millimeters before now measures around 1,000 millimeters. Notice how the program recognizes where the endpoint of each line or corner is, making it easy to snap onto it. As soon as a shape has four corners on the same drawing axis, it will automatically form a side with its own clickable surface. Let us continue now to draw the cube shape. Remember to use the VCB at the bottom right of the screen, and typing the desired line length on the keyboard, and pressing Enter. In this example, I entered the value of 1000, and the line was created to that length. Let us now explore viewing angles by clicking on the View toolbar at the top of the main screen, on the menu bar. See what happens when we select different views. Also notice that the model seemed to have spun around 180 degrees. What actually happened is that we, the viewer, is now viewing it from the opposite angle. In other words, we have changed position and not the model. To restore yourself to the original viewing angle, use the Orbit tool. This tool is situated on the left of the screen on the side toolbar. Or click and hold the scroll button whilst moving the mouse, and restoring the viewpoint to a point closest to where you first started. Now click on the ISO view, short for isometric view, and the original view is restored if that is the view you started in. Let's just recap, the Orbit tool is activated when holding the scroll button down. If you want to position the object towards the middle of your screen, then click the pan button, or the hand icon. To zoom in and out, use the mouse scroll button, or go to the side toolbar and select the magnifying glass. Let us continue now to draw the cube shape. Notice how the program recognizes where the endpoint of each line or corner is, making it easy to snap onto it. After drawing the lines for the cube, all the sides will automatically snap together to form an enclosed object. I would like to now make the object stand out more against the background. Left click to highlight the surface, followed by right click, and select the top option, namely Entity Info. Click on either the inside or outside face, click Edit, and pick a color. Or as shown here, click the Paint Bucket icon, and see all the available options for giving a skin to your object. Now we can see our object more clearly. There are a few more view options available to the SketchUp user. One of those is called Perspective View, and the other is called Parallel Projection. Parallel projection is great if you do not want to see a slightly skewed image caused by viewing an object in perspective. Closer object surfaces appear larger than more distant object surfaces in perspective mode. It is sometimes important to view an object in parallel view, especially to get a clear front, side, and top view. It is always a good idea to consolidate all the sides and lines into one object so that it cannot be accidentally changed. Do this by highlighting the entire object with a left mouse click, hold, and drag movement. Right click and select, make a group, or on the top menu bar select, edit, and make group. The entire object has now been isolated from any other objects that you still want to draw and cannot impact on each other. It is also handy to group an object, so that it can be manipulated as a whole. In this instance, I selected the scale tool and one click on the grouped model will activate pull points in order to grow or shrink the object in a desired direction along an axis. With the dimension tool, apply dimensions to the object. The object can be scaled about opposite point to increase or decrease the length of the object. Make the object see-through, as shown here. Your first instinct may be to type in the required length in the VCP, but this is what happens. It extends the object by a factor of 1,500. Instead, the correct action should have been to apply a ratio of 1.5 times 1,000, which will extend the object length to 1,500. An easier way would be to use the push-pull tool. Make sure the object is centered on the axis convergence point. The push-pull tool does not work when the object is grouped. Ungroup the object and select the push-pull tool from the side toolbar. Now you can type in a value into the VCP, hit enter, and increase or decrease the object in that way. Once you are happy with the object you created, along with dimensions, a two-dimensional image of the object can be exported as a PNG file. Note that on the bottom right of the screen there is an Options tab. Select it, and specify your preferred image resolution. The file should also be saved as a SketchUp file. If it needs to be shared with others, make sure to save it in a format that they can open in their own SketchUp versions. For instance, a file saved in a newer version cannot be opened in an older version, so save it in an older version for selected customers. Now that the file is saved, I would like to highlight another advantage of grouping objects together. Let me show by example. Note that once an object is ungrouped and touches an adjacent object, it will impact on that object. I hope you benefited from this tutorial. Please like and subscribe to my channel. Let me know what you want to see in future tutorials in the comments below. There are a lot of ways in which your business can benefit from this software, just like mine did. Thanks for watching. Your business in 3D. Till next time, goodbye.